I don't know. So, obviously I didn't change my pants. Like, I brought my good pants to put on, but then I thought, fuck it. I don't know. So, they wanted to come on out and say hi. They said, you know, every night, you know, you take us off and then you put the other pants on. Like, all right, I'll put you on and you can come out and say hello and be admired by all. So January 28th, we all lost a beautiful, beautiful friend. We lost such a great composer, songwriter, and one of the most innovative guitar players and co-founder of television, Tom Verlaine. Miss him very much. I met Tom in 1974, and Tom and I, we had the same, almost the same exact books. Like, we met, we liked each other, but when we saw each other's bookcases, we were there. And he was awesome, so funny. And this is a little song that Tom wrote for Marquee Moon, and we'd like to do it in remembrance of him. Thank you.
Thank you.
being skin. So I don't know, was it the 90s? I think it was the 90s. We toured with Bob Dylan, and gave me this book, and what's on the poop on the back? It's probably cat piss, really. It's all right. I don't mind. It was a good cat. Sorry. And I was allowed to, I was given the book and allowed to pick any song I wanted to sing with Bob. And it still has the little thing on it, because I chose Dark Eyes, and I still have the little tab. I mean, there's Dark Eyes. And so I still have the book. And in this book is a song that I listened to many times when I was a young teenager, probably about 15, 16 years old. And it was very relevant then. And I think, unfortunately, it's even more relevant now. And since I've lost my place, I'll just have to keep, that's what happens when you, you know, take the piece of paper out that showed you where you were gonna be, and here we go. So, thank you, Bob Dylan, for all the years. Thank you. watching it rise. Tattooed fingers shut away from me. Voices mesmerize. Voices beckon and see. Rid of the fucking postman and start over. Watch me now. The boy was in the hallway drinking a glass of tea. From the other end of the hallway, a rhythm was generating. Johnny feel the energy coming toward him. Wasn't a bad energy, wasn't a good energy, it was just energy that is ready to break open, change a whole heart. The rhythm was generating. Johnny just stood there and said, okay, come on. Come on. Come on, motherfucker. Come on. Come on. The boy looked at Johnny. Johnny wanted to run. Johnny wanted to move, but the movie kept moving as planned. The boy gripped Johnny. He pressed him against the locker. He drove him in, he drove it hard, he drove it deep in Johnny. The boy disappeared. Johnny started crashing his head against the locker. Crashing his head against the locker. Started laughing hysterically. When suddenly Johnny gets a feeling. He spins around to buy horses, 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 horses. Shining silver, studs with the nose. ABCs. In the distance on a hill, a large golden egg. He walks toward it. little song that I read for my boyfriend, and my boyfriend became the father of Jackson and Jesse. Thank you. Take me now, baby, here as I am. Pull me close, try and understand. Desire is hunger, is the fire I breathe. Love is a banquet on which we feed. So we'd like to do one more song for you. And Fred and I wrote this song in 1986 when Jackson was just a little boy Jesse wasn't born yet, and to have them both playing on Fred's song is just so awesome. And when Jesse was quite young, her schoolmate Laura and her used to sing all the time, so I dragged Laura on stage because I want her to sing on the chorus. What about Italy? It's a great country. Oh, family. Yes, family, friends, schoolmates, all of you guys, and thank you very much. I know it. I had a rocky start. I'm still like getting my feet on the ground. But thank you. Thank you.
Yeah.
dream.